Hello there, everyone, and welcome to the Social Justice Play Series. This is a collaboration between Needham Community Theatre and a Common Thread Theatre company, and we're so thrilled to have you today. And we just wanted to remind you that after the show, there is a Q&A. So if you have any questions as you are watching, feel free to use the Q&A function at the bottom of the screen to be able to add your questions, and then we will answer them at the end during that session. So we hope that you enjoy this performance, and we look forward to you joining in on the discussion after the show.
Hey, what rhymes with Juneteenth?
I'm not sure. That's a hard one. Juneteenth. Juneteenth. Juneteenth.
I've been sitting here blank for 10 minutes.
What are you doing?
It's for school. We're supposed to present about our favorite holiday.
I thought your favorite was Halloween.
It is Halloween.
So why are you asking me how to rhyme Juneteenth?
Because this year for Halloween, I'm going as a liberation soldier in 1865. Went down to Galveston, Texas to deliver the news that enslaved people were free. Did you know that it took 2 years after the Emancipation Proclamation?
Wow.
I love soldiers, and I thought, wouldn't it be cool to be one of the soldiers who marched all the way down to Galveston, Texas, to deliver the good news to hundreds of enslaved people?
So, your report is not about Halloween.
Well, the report is, but the rap will be about Juneteenth.
So, your report it is about Halloween, and your rap is about Juneteenth.
Exactly. Every kid knows about Halloween, but not everybody knows about Juneteenth. So putting in rap makes sense, right?
Yes, it does.
I just need to think of a rhyme.
Maybe you break it in half, rhyme June and then teenth. So moon and
Moon thief?
Juneteenth, moon thief.
But what does liberating enslaved people have to do with stealing the moon?
Good question. What if you didn't rhyme Juneteenth, but rhyme the words around them?
I thought of that, but if I can think of a good rhyme for Juneteenth, more people will remember it. That's what rhymes are for.
True.
Juneteenth.
Let me check the rhyming website.
There's a rhyming website?
Yep. Okay. Juneteenth.
Is it cheating using a rhyming website?
No more or less than using a dictionary. Nope. Nothing rhymes with Juneteenth. Well, don't get frustrated. We'll figure this out. You know what? I rapped a little in middle school. Well, once. Some friends and I went as the hip-hop group Arrested Development for Halloween.
Who?
Doesn't matter. We learned one of the songs and performed it at the Halloween school assembly.
You did?
I think your grandma has a video of it else somewhere. I was Speech, the lead rapper, and I really had to study his lyrics. And the one thing I noticed is that he never actually rhymes the entire words 10EC. He just rhymes B and C. For some strange reason, it had to be, guided me to Tennessee. So don't get caught up in trying to find the perfect rhyme. There are lots of ways to make it work.
How?
You tell me. What's Juneteenth?
A celebration?
Of?
Being free?
Free rhymes with a lot, doesn't it?
It does. It does so many things. Here, let me change it.
You ready to try it out?
Okay, so pretend I'm in my liberation soldier uniform.
Oh my gosh. You look amazing.
Thank you. You all know the story. Divided states, civil wars, bullets and hate, brother versus brother, slave versus master, a bloody chapter of the American disaster. Lincoln had a plan to free every man, woman and girl, enslaved in the land. The South said, wait, that's not your call. The war wasn't over. The news got stalled. 2 years later, emancipation, black people were enslaved. I said black and not African-American because African-American has too many syllables.
Ah, no problem. Keep going.
Okay, let me start back a bit. The South said, wait, that's not your call. The war wasn't over. The news got stalled. 2 years later, emancipation, black people were enslaved across the nation. They didn't know the South would lose, and soon they'd get their freedom news. Until then, they stayed in danger, waiting on the troops of General Granger. June 19th was the date. Jubilee, jubilee, let's celebrate. And word spread across the South, that's what Juneteenth is about. So from Texas to Tennessee, hip hip hooray, now we're free. June is here, we are free. Celebrate this day for eternity. We are free, we are free. June is here, it's a jubilee. When I say June, you say teenth. June.
Teenth.
June.
Teenth.
And one more thing I must say, Juneteenth is my real favorite holiday. I just made that last part up in my head just now.
How subversive.
What does subversive mean?
It means that you are the best kind of liberation soldier. And for that, you get ice cream.
We lived next door to each other as kids.
And now, same city.
We were never that close during any of it, but we knew each other.
I'd see him here and there.
We were aware of one another.
We kept our space. Not consciously, we just ran in different spaces.
But we were always aware. Social war.
Another body, another name, another image has circulated. The latest body, name, the newest image to haunt.
Shameful.
I posted, this is no time for apathy.
I liked it.
The fight for equality continues on.
Liked it.
And then I typed a hashtag in three words. Words I thought anyone could get behind.
I didn't quite like that. I responded with a hashtag in three words. Nothing offensive, just words I thought anyone could get behind.
I didn't quite like it, so I deleted it.
She deleted my response. Totally hypocritical.
My wall, my space. And yeah, I edit it. It's the one space where I can build the world I'd like to inhabit.
I respond to her posts a lot. We share the same algorithm, politically.
My response was to remove it.
Erasure is never okay. So I responded, this is not a race issue, not really. This is about abuse of power.
I responded, are you crazy?
And I responded, we're talking about equality, the human experience. No time for stark divisions along racial lines. This is a time for us to recognize our shared humanity.
I deleted it.
I messaged her.
He messaged me.
We haven't seen each other in a while or spoken. The last time was at a concert. She was a little mad at me because the MC performed a song with the N-word in the chorus. And she saw me sing along. And she never said anything, but after the show, she was cold to me.
He messaged me.
Hey, Kim. I know it's been a while.
He felt like we needed to talk, needed to clear the air.
Can we sit down for coffee sometime? Sitting down.
I want to ask you what you meant, but I'm finding it hard to ask you. What I'd rather do is just tell you what I think about what I thought you meant.
I can explain what I meant.
I'm sure you can, but can you explain what I read and what I took it to mean?
I just meant that we are all comprised of matter. Matter being that essential molecular element of which we were all built. Ordinary matter like trees and water, solids and liquids.
But sounds, the voice, for example, was not always considered matter. Matter used to only encompass a select set of solid objects.
But all along, it was all matter.
What happens to matter split? Does it explode and decimate millions of bodies of color? And whose hands split that matter? What we are talking about are Black lives split, shaken until they become bombs.
Oh, their lives, those lives. It's all ridiculous. We're here. And we can decide the way this is going to go. Right? And this doesn't have to, shouldn't be. And we, us, we don't have to ascribe. And aside, there was that summer after senior year of high school. We were both short on credits. All our friends took off and we had to stick around. We both ended up working at the library to make extra cash. We got kind of close that summer. We talked about books, smoked joints on lunch break. That was the summer I got into R&B and I turned her onto some indie rock. I thought, man, what a cool chick. Oh, there was that one night after our shift. We got those tall cans and decided to break into the school. We heard someone, so we ducked into the only open room we could find, the chemistry room. It was dark in there and we were super quiet. We drank more and started to get close. Maybe it's because things were coming to an end. We got close to, but we didn't. She stopped suddenly. Said she had to go home. We are on the same side, Kim.
Are we?
Yes, we want the same thing.
Another man is lying in the street. Your immediate impulse is to correct me, to talk semantics with me, to say, well, actually, Kim, I don't know what side that is. An aside. In particle physics, antimatter is material composed of antiparticles, which have the same mass as particles of ordinary matter, but have an opposite charge.
I don't think anyone is less or more or special.
When we say Black Lives Matter, do you think that's us saying we're special? Look at us. We're getting shot.
No, it's sort of like making your suffering worse than others. Wait.
What did you just?
That's not what I mean. It's saying your suffering is, I mean, okay, what about in Africa, all the Boko Haram stuff, or women all over the world being assaulted, gays,
okay, lesbians, but we're
Hispanics being deported, shot at border crossings, or hell, even poor white folks who live in black communities who are bullied because of the crimes of others.
Cole,
I'm all for civil rights and looting, but property damage,
no,
rage,
no,
it doesn't work. It's not strategic. All lives, Kim. All lives. That's what I'm saying. Let's pull the act from the context of race. We have to break this down to the root. Human wickedness.
And sometimes humans kill humans because of their race.
Wouldn't it be great? I just wish we could move on. Be ourselves, be individuals, be our own perfect stars. Just be our own perfect stars. When we were kids, when we'd have that block party, all the kids would be out and getting our faces painted like Spider-Man, bike races. We were just kids in the neighborhood. When did we start?
I was the only black kid at that block party.
I didn't see it like that.
You didn't see I was black?
I didn't treat you different.
Not everybody was like you.
In aside, she wasn't always like this.
In aside, I was silent. I used to be silent.
She used to be real easy going. Cool chick.
I used to hold my breath, breathe shallow, up here in my chest.
We grew up the same way.
But the way we are perceived is different.
That doesn't mean those perceptions are true.
The water and the tree are in the same forest, but not the same. Different mass, different volume, different uses. Are you willing to decrease your mass? Just say it. Black lives matter.
Do white lives not matter?
Nobody is saying what doesn't matter.
But it's exclusionary.
It's contextual. In this climate, it relates to the splitting of black atoms with no consequence.
And aside, I really want to leave. I feel sick. I want to hug Kim and tell her I'm sorry. But if I'm being honest, tell her to get over it. Life is hard, and there's no measuring stick for suffering. She can change this just by being herself. Not this angry black woman.
An aside, I really want to let Cole off the hook. Drop this whole thing. Tell him it's all good. But I have swallowed myself so many times to make white folks feel less uncomfortable.
I just want to fix it.
Cole wants to know how we fix it. Wants me to tell him, but I just woke up this way. I don't know how to dig into the heart's rewire the circuitry. Who does? All I'm trying to do is keep it together.
I I want to tell her I'm sorry.
I don't need apologies. I just wanted to stop.
To say it is to admit that my life, in someone's eyes, people living, people dead, has mattered more than other folks. And I don't think it does, but someone at some point has believed that. And maybe my life has been better because of that.
That night in the chemistry room, when we got close, Cole and I, all those years ago, I was into it. I liked him. Until he put his hands in my hair. I thought about all those kids in school always asking to touch it. Can I touch it? And how they'd react when they did. And he had his hands in my hair, and I wondered how it felt. Weird? Funny? Good? Then I thought about if he'd been with any Black girls before, and it was too much. So I told him I had to go home. So I did. I left, and that was the closest we ever got.
A week or two later, I sent Kim a message. I thanked her for the conversation and told her we should be in touch more often. That I wanted to keep talking, not just about this, but our lives in general. Nothing. That was that, I thought. One morning, I went on my timeline and I saw her picture and her name being shared by everyone. They called it a failure to comply, a failure to be silent. So she was made silent forever. She lives on now as a hashtag. But I still hear her voice hanging in the particles. Does the spirit have mass? It must. I can feel the weight.
But I feel like this. How many mothers have to cry? How many brothers gotta die? How many more times? How many more times? How many more marches?
You just press the button and it goes up like whoosh, just by pressing the button. Cindy has the best toys.
That's great, Sam.
Yeah, so awesome, so awesome. And that's not all. That's not all.
No.
They have a dog, a cat, and an iguana. Can you believe that?
And an iguana?
Yep, yep. His name is Ivan. Ivan the iguana. And guess what the cat's name is?
Oh, that's nice.
Are you listening?
I am. Yes, I am.
I asked if you could guess the cat's name, and you said, that's real nice.
I misunderstood you. I'm listening. See? I put my phone down.
The cat's name, guess.
What is the cat's name?
Try and guess.
Furball?
No.
Well?
Obama.
Really?
Yep.
That's so cute.
Yeah, because he's half black and half white.
I'm sorry, what?
Some of the cat fur is black and some is white. And it's It's so much fun at Cindy's house.
Mm-hmm. How are Cindy's parents towards you?
What do you mean?
How do they treat you?
What do you mean?
Are they nice to you?
Of course they're nice to me.
Do they ever say anything that makes you feel uncomfortable?
No, Cindy's my friend.
Because if they do, you can tell me. Matter of fact, I need you to tell me if they do.
It's okay. We're just having fun. Hey, hey, you want to know what else?
What else?
We had a huge water fight.
Oh, yeah?
It was so cool. Cindy's mom filled up a bucket with water balloons and buckets. And know what else?
What else? What else?
Oh, nothing.
Well, now you got me all curious. Tell me.
Nothing.
Was it water guns? Was it water guns, Sam? Hey, it's okay. I'm not mad.
You're not?
No, I understand. You were having fun.
It was so much fun!
And when you're at someone else's house, that's fine.
It was so much fun. Cindy has one of the shoot that shoots water so far.
Oh, yeah?
So far.
But Cindy knows that when she comes to our house, we don't do that.
I told her.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I told her, her mom, and her dad.
And what did they say?
They didn't say anything.
Nothing?
Nope. They just did this.
Well, did you tell them why?
No.
You have to tell them why, Sam.
I don't know why.
Of course you know why.
I don't know why.
Sam, come on. We talked about this.
But then I don't understand. A water gun is plastic and it's colorful and it's just water. It's not real.
But it is a gun.
For water, there are guns that light up, make noise, guns that are just like space alien guns.
But you remember the days that we bring snack to school? And we have to be careful to bring something that everyone can eat?
Yes.
Why do we do that, Sam?
Because some kids couldn't have dairy or gluten or meat.
And why is that?
They don't feel good.
We have to be considerate of other people's allergies. And you know what happens when people's allergies act up?
They don't feel good.
Right. They don't feel good and they get sick. Well, guns make me sick. Even if it's a toy gun, it has a barrel and it has a trigger and I have a reaction.
What kind?
You know, some nights when you have bad dreams.
Yes.
I have them sometimes in the daytime. Even when I'm awake and when I think of you with a gun, even a toy gun, I have quick bad dreams in my head.
What kind?
Something happens when toys are in the hands of children, especially little brown-skinned children like you.
What happens to them?
Sometimes grown-ups can't tell the difference between something being a toy and something being real. Even if you're playing, everyone isn't in on the game.
Oh. I have an idea.
What's your idea?
To let everyone know we're just playing, we can sing a song.
What kind of song?
The water gun song.
The water gun song? How does the water gun song go?
Water gun, it's so fun. It's so fun. Sing it too, sing it too.
Water gun, it's so fun. It's so fun.
It's just a game. It's not real. It's just pretend. It's not real.
It's just a game. It's not real. It's just pretend. It's not real.
What about that? Maybe that would help.
Well, maybe, but either way, I'd like it.
When you get the bad dreams, you can just sing that song.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
Oh, you know what else?
So, hey, you know that Obama, the person, not the cat, he's more than just his colors, right?
Of course.
Okay, just checking.
How about nunchucks? Can I have nunchucks in the house?
We'll talk about it.
Hey, you know what else?
Please ain't water guns and please save all our sons and daughters, what we fighting for. Cause these ain't water guns no more. And these ain't water guns and please save all our sons and daughters, what we fighting for. Cause these ain't water guns no more.
One day when the glory comes, it will be ours, it will be ours. Oh, one day when the war is won, we will be sure, we will be sure. Oh, glory,
glory, glory.
Oh,
glory, glory.
Hands to the heavens, no man, no weapon formed against, yes, glory is destined. Everyday women and men become legends. Sins that go against our skin become blessings. The movement is a rhythm to us. Freedom is like religion to us. Justice is juxtaposition in us. Justice for all just ain't specific enough. One son died, his spirit is revisiting us. True and living, living in us. Resistance is us. That's why Rosa sat on the bus. That's why we walk through Ferguson with our hands up. When it go down, we woman and man up. They say stay down, and we stand up. Shots, we on the ground, the camera panned up. King pointed to the mountaintop, and we ran up.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours, it will be ours. Oh, glory. Oh,
glory, glory.
Now the war is not over, victory isn't won.
Obama is now for every man, woman, and child. Even Jesus got his crown in front of a crowd. They march with the torch, we gon' run with it now. Never look back, we done gone hundreds of miles. From dark roads, heroes, to become a hero. Facing the League of Justice, his power was the people. Enemy is lethal, a king became regal. Saw the face of Jim Crow under a bald ego. No one can win a war individually. It take the wisdom of the elders and young people's energy. Welcome to the story we call victory. The coming of the Lord, my eyes have seen the glory.
One day, when the glory comes,